Cleveland, Ohio, Jarvis Landry has had to serve as his own doctor at times during COVID-19, but he deserves a 5-star rating for the progress he's made in his rehab from hip surgery in February.
"Right now, I'm a little bit ahead of schedule," Landry said on Zoom call with Browns media on Wednesday. "But the most important thing right now is just taking it day by day. You know, I can't predict when exactly I'll be on the field, whether that's July, August, or September, but obviously my return day is sometime in August."
Amid the coronavirus pandemic, Landry has had to take medical matters into his own hands, literally.
"As far as on a modality side, I've learned how to cup myself," he said, referring to suction therapy. "I've learned how to dry needle myself, and those are just things that over time that I've picked up, obviously consulting with them first about what I'm feeling and where I'm feeling these things at and what are the best modalities that I can do outside of jumping in the pool or riding a bike or something like that."
Despite his initial decision not to have the procedure, he's glad he did.
"Absolutely. Absolutely," he said. "It's something I knew I needed, and I was going to try to put off and play tough guy for one more year. Just understanding where I was and the things my injury was not allowing me to do, I didn't want to be part of the reason for the team not having success or myself not having success. Unselfishly, I decided just to go ahead and have the surgery."
Except for having to stick and cup himself, Landry hasn't been limited as much one might think by the stay-at-home orders during his rehab. He's been training at Barwis Performance Center in Deerfield Beach, Florida, and hearing regularly from Browns physical therapist Anthony Trim.
"He's doing an amazing job checking in with me every morning and every afternoon to make sure I'm okay, sending me things to do, if I have any problems or soreness or tightness," he said. "I've also been working with one of my primary doctors, Dr. Chad Teague. We have processes and it's going great."
Landry hadn't seen his best Odell Beckham Jr. in person during the rehab process, but they've pushed other daily to come back from their procedures, Beckham from core muscle surgery in January. In fact, Beckham vowed recently to come back bigger, stronger, faster, and predicts one of his best career seasons.
"We've been FaceTiming," Landry said. "We've been kind of documenting our whole process of recovery and sending it back and forth to each other. Obviously right now is, like I said, it's a crucial time in our recovery stages of getting our strength back. The healing process is kind of done. Now it's time to make sure that everything's working together."
And then being able to go in the right phases and the right stages to be able to translate that all back to the field. "Seeing his process has been motivating me obviously from afar, which he does automatically. The player he is, his work ethic motivates me. And going back and forth with our videos about just where we are in our rehab process is something that has been encouraging us to get even better than we were before."
Unfortunately for both, they've had to miss out on Camp Mayfield, the workout sessions Baker Mayfield hosted last week in Austin, Texas for teammates such as Austin Hooper, David Joku, Rashard Higgins, Damian Ratley and others.
"Yeah, I mean, I thought about going, but at the end of the day I'm in a crucial part of my rehab process," Landry said. "You know, going out there for a couple of days and I would have to figure out all the logistics of trying to get, you know, a doctor out there, make sure I had a weight room and things like that. I didn't think it would be worth it."
But those guys made the most of it, made the best of it, got better for that week that went out there. "We still did Zoom calls and Zoom meetings throughout the week, so I was able to be a part of their learning process."
He applauded Mayfield for taking the initiative to host the sessions.
"Baker's done a great job making sure that everybody's on the same page and staying together, even getting guys together," Landry said. "It's really forefronted by coach Kevin Stefanski. He's encouraging us to continue to look at our playbook. Obviously, this is optional, encouraging us to be on these Zoom calls, Zoom meetings, to make sure that we can get on the same page and not lose days because of what we're going through."
He admitted he misses his longtime receivers coach Adam Henry, who dated all the way back to LSU, but is excited about his position coach Chad O'Shea, who won 2 Super Bowls with the Patriots.
"Obviously, given our history, it was tough," he said. But Chad is also a guy that has proven history, has been on Super Bowl teams, coached Super Bowl teams, won a Super Bowls, lost a Super Bowl or two, and has a history of coaching a lot of receivers that play in the slot, that play on the outside.
We talk a lot about just the option route. He's had guys like Julian Edelman, who is arguably one of the best guys in the NFL to be able to run an option route and make the right decision all the time. We've just kind of been talking and critiquing my game and finding ways to allow me to do what I do best, and our relationship is obviously building and growing.
He acknowledged that he worried about his wife and two young kids while rehabbing the injury amid COVID-19.
I took about a month where it was kind of just me going back and forth on FaceTime and using Zoom calls to be able to go through my workout with doctors and things like that to make that I was staying the course, he said, adding that Jarvis goes to extreme lengths to keep athletes healthy.
The Browns NFLPA rep, Landry, echoed the sentiments of his teammates J.C. Treader, the new NFLPA president, that the player's safety is paramount.
This is a time right now where, obviously, the world needs something, he said. The world needs sports. The fans need sports. Everybody is looking forward to football season, being that's the only season that seems to be on schedule right now. For me, just looking at it, number one, is just to make sure that everybody's safe, from the players to the fans to everybody in the whole entire world, because this is affecting a lot of people right now.
When football does resume, Landry, who hasn't missed a game in his six NFL seasons, plans to be on the field.
Obviously, that's one of the biggest things for me. That's one of the goals that I would set out for myself since I was a kid watching Monday Night Football, he said. And it's still something that's in the back of mind. Obviously, I want to make sure that I'm going through this process the right way, too, and making sure that I'm healthy enough to be able to go out there and help the team win games and not hurt the team. Yeah, that is in my mind, but I'm really focused on this rehab to make sure that I can be ready for the season.
New Browns face masks for sale. Here's where you can buy Cleveland Browns themed face coverings for coronavirus protection for adults and youth, including a single mask, $14.99, and a three-pack, $24.99. All NFL proceeds donated to CDC Foundation.
More Browns coverage.
Constructing the Browns offensive depth chart for 2020, big investments to boost Baker Mayfield.
Browns J.C. Treader on the NFL's return, the virus isn't going to kneel down to almighty football.
Will money issues torpedo MLB's return? Bud Shaw talks baseball, Browns on Tuesday's More Sports and Less Levine.
NFL tables proposal to incentivize minority hirings of coaches, front office personnel, according to report.
Browns 2020 preseason schedule dates and times finalized.
Which defensive players could earn long-term deals? Orange and Brown Talk Podcast.
Why ESPN's Dan Orlovsky believes Baker Mayfield is poised for a big year, Orange and Brown Talk Podcast.
Terry Pluto, what can we expect from Cleveland Browns this season? How about less dumb football?
How Callie Brownson found the door to the NFL and Kevin Stefanski's staff.
Can the Browns win with a rookie left tackle? Three high draft picks who did not work out as expected.
Can the Browns win with a rookie left tackle? Six high picks who have worked.
Is an offensive regression looming for Baltimore? What does it mean for Browns?